Faced with mounting pressure from the governor and fellow Democrats, State Senator Martin Sandoval has resigned as chairman of the Senate's Transportation Committee.
We've also just learned of another resignation as the fallout from this federal corruption probe continues. WGN's Megan Dwyer joins us now with the latest. Megan?
To be very clear, nobody here has been charged with any wrongdoing, but we are certainly learning more today about this probe. It has now entangled state agencies, various politicians, and some very large corporations. And Santoy has just resigned from the Tollway Board after being pressured by Governor Pritzker.
Corruption and self-dealing are unacceptable and will be rooted out, whether it's in my administration or in the legislature.
Cesar Santoy, an alderman in Berwyn, was appointed by Governor Pritzker to the Illinois Toll Highway Authority in February.
From my perspective, Cesar Santoy should step aside from his position on the Tollway Board.
Hours later, he did. He is now the second politician to step down from a leadership position since reporters obtained this unredacted federal search warrant today. Executed last month at Senator Sandoval's Springfield office, it shows the FBI was looking for evidence of federal corruption, including bribery, theft from a federally funded program, mail and wire fraud, and interference with commerce by threats or violence, specifically items related to any official action taken in exchange for a benefit. State Senator Martin Sandoval didn't give a reason for stepping down today. He just wrote this letter, which read, quote, "I am resigning as chairperson for the Senate Transportation Committee."
He's overseeing a $45 billion road construction project. Can you imagine that? And this is a guy who the feds just raided his offices 2 weeks ago.
He still retains his seat and remains a top Democrat in the Senate. The unredacted warrant mentions specific officials who work for ComEd Exelon and the Illinois Department of Transportation, a red light camera vendor in the suburbs, and high-profile gambling operators, some who have been trying to get a horse race track and casino up and running in Tinley Park. The corruption probe has named several communities in Sandoval's district like Cicero, and it's named politicians like Jeff Tobolsky, the mayor of McCook, Stephen Landeck, a state senator and the mayor of Bridgeview, and John Harris, Rod Blagojevich's former chief of staff. The list of items the FBI took from Sandoval's Springfield office includes computers, cell phones, shredded paper, documents related to his personal business, a fundraising spreadsheet, and a flash drive with the word Landeck written on it. State Senator Landeck did not return our calls for comment, neither did the mayor of McCook. Santoy's attorney, though, told the Chicago Tribune Santoy is not a target of this probe. The FBI simply wanted some records, and he is confident these legal concerns will clear up soon. Joe, Dina.
Thank you, Megan.